Les risques émergents. Qu'est-ce que c'est qu'un risque
émergent?
En épidémiologie,
what is an emerging risk or threat? In epidemiology, we call emergent risks new diseases, new affections, new risks, not the disease itself, which appear in a determined space in France, in the region Auvergne or across the world, for that matter. It is therefore necessary to determine which space, and this within a very limited period of time. This year, this month, this decade, this century, possibly, it needs to be defined. An emerging risk of human origin, climatic risks of human origin affect the whole planet, but their morbid expression depends very much on the development degree of the area according to the geography. So relativization is very important when we talk about emerging risks. What are the current emerging risks across the world age?
Why?
Because man is responsible for the fact that people live longer. Human activity has beneficial effects, whereby we live longer. We have longer life expectancy. Our life expectancy has approximately doubled during the 20th century. The climate also is responsible for a huge risk. Sun rays, there are climatic pollution, surface ozone, fine and ultrafine particles, toxic risks and pesticides, infectious risks, new pathogen related infections, allergens, pollens, and fungi, agricultural yield and fish resources, immune risk and metabolic risk. I'm going to try and illustrate some of these elements. Age. This curve comes from a daily in France, the Figaro, showing that ever since 1710 or 1750, life expectancy has been increasing regularly. There were some troughs, for instance, during the Napoleonic Wars and the last two World Wars, 1914 and 1939. There are also extrapolations. We can extrapolate the life expectancy increase curve until 2100, then we may think that at that time we will live to be 130 years old. Except that in the meantime, a nuclear catastrophe could happen, or a viral, or a climatic catastrophe, and in that case, life expectancy would drop dramatically.
Il y a actuellement évidence que l'espérance de vie a l'air de ralentir.
Apparently, the speed at which life expectancy increases seems to slow down slightly, but this is not well documented.
Les maladies émergentes.
Emerging diseases.
Une maladie, c'est pas un risque. Une maladie,
a disease is not a risk. It's more than a risk.
La liste des maladies émergentes,
the list of emerging diseases
correspond à la liste des risques émergents,
matches the list of emerging risks, but not 100%. There are emerging diseases for which we have no known origin.
En 2014, le premier des risques, c'est l'âge.
The risk number one is age, and the most frequent affections have to do with age, nothing to do with biodiversity, but this is our current daily work for GPs or medical doctors, family doctors. Four main groups, skin cancers, directly linked with the sun rays, and the global warming phenomenon, but also for UV cabins used for sun tanning. The Medicine Academy that I belong to has several times requested that these cabins be banned because they are responsible for skin cancers. Skin cancer is not a very frequent disease, but the incidence increases year after year. And there are age-related diseases we have mentioned before, cancers, cardiovascular diseases, neurodegenerative diseases. Alzheimer's disease is becoming a huge public health problem, not only in terms of health, but also everything around health, because we need paramedics to take care of the Alzheimer's disease patients. And financially speaking, this is going to become a huge issue. Finally, new infectious diseases and autoimmune and allergic diseases, such as asthma or ileitis, or intestinal diseases such as Crohn's disease, the incidence of which doubles every year approximately.
L'augmentation de la durée moyenne
age-related diseases. The increase of the life expectancy is due to better lifestyle, better hygiene, progress made by medicine and the health organization, also better eating habits. Longevity is linked with different parameters, but it's directly linked with the human activity and the beneficial side of human activity. Now, longevity has no direct relation with biodiversity and the changes in biodiversity, but it has changed the medical landscape by making non-transmissible age-related diseases the major cause of mortality and morbidity. And in economic terms, this group of diseases is the most expensive one for the community in all the countries across the world. And we have to take this into consideration.
Le risque infectieux.
Infectious risk.
There are two aspects
in the infectious risk.
Trop de bactéries.
It's either too much or too many bacteria, or too many infectious agents.
Ou le SRAS.
Ebola virus or AIDS or SRAS, but there is also the not enough aspect. There are risks due to the disappearance of some bacteria. This is the famous hygienistic assumption, too much hygiene, too much cleanliness and total absence of bacteria is responsible for the appearance of autoimmune diseases and allergic diseases. We need to live with some pathogens, some infectious agents or bacteria. But we need to find the balance, and the balance is not always easy to strike, especially for public health purposes. Too many infectious agents, the new infectious risks. There is a risk which is very famous, the malaria. Malaria kills millions of people across the world. It is a world endemic, and we might fear that because of global warming, the effect on the pathogen and the multiplication of transport, malaria is going to spread, except that because of preventative measures, malaria tends to decrease rather than increase, and the danger of it disseminating to northern hemisphere countries is relatively limited. This is an example showing that the increase of temperature, global warming, increase of temperature in vitro, well, as in vitro temperature increases, the number of days during which Plasmodium falciparum will be able to trigger the disease will increase. There is a direct link between temperature and the biology of the bug, except that this connection is only one of the many different elements responsible for the spread of malaria, also called paludism, but it's the same word, malaria.
Quand on classe les agents associés à l'émergence et à la réémergence,
when we classify agents combined with emergence or reemergence of human pathogens, we find quite surprisingly that climate changes only come in 10th position. There are changes in the soil, precariousness of sanitary conditions, nosocomial infections, evolution of pathogens, contamination through food or water, trips and intercontinental exchanges, precariousness, disorganization of healthcare systems, or the absence thereof. The lower price of transport of goods and animals are much more responsible for the emergence and reemergence of human pathogens than climate changes. But as I said, sometimes there are not enough bacteria, the immune disease and autoimmune diseases. The immune risk in autoimmune diseases. This is a picture drawn from Jean-François Bach, and he was the first one to point out this aspect. On the left-hand side graph, you see the incidence of a number of infectious diseases, tuberculosis, hepatitis, mumps, measles. The incidence decreases dramatically due to preventative vaccination and hygiene actions. And anti-vaccination campaigns right now are criminal. Vaccination should continue. And on the right-hand side, we have the non-parallel increase of autoimmune diseases and allergic diseases. Type 1 diabetes is an autoimmune disease, multiple sclerosis, ileitis, Crohn's disease. They all tend to increase, and this is one of the many curves in favor, in support of the hygienist theory, according to which too much hygiene leads to deficiencies in the immune system and an increase in the incidence of autoimmune diseases.
Un exemple de complicité
complexity that is very difficult to simplify, the role played by climate changes in the increased frequency of asthma, multiplied by 5 over the last 10 years, due to a decrease in infections and parasitosis, the hygienist assumption that I described, but also an increase in triggering factors, the quantity of pollen, the richness of pollen that contains more allergens.
1 gram
of pollen contains more allergens than it used to because of human activity, and therefore pollen is more toxic. And the season of pollination, and earlier in the spring happens earlier, the fall happens later. So we cannot summarize asthma to one of these three elements. They must all be present.